BlenderKit is an amazing resource for Blender, a 3D modeling program that is open source. BlenderKit has many, many assets that you can use in your 3D modeling projects, many times royalty-free. There's even a paid plan that gives you access to more assets. But how do we install BlenderKit to be able to use it with Blender? Especially, how do we install BlenderKit with Blender 4.2? The first thing to do is to go to BlenderKit.com. Then click Download BlenderKit. This will download a zip file that has everything that you need to know. It's important to note that earlier versions of BlenderKit did not work with 4.2, so go ahead and download the most recent version. Once you have the BlenderKit zip file in your downloads, you're ready to open up Blender and install. Make sure that it's still a zip file. Sometimes you may have your browser set that it automatically extracts zip files. If that's the case and you have a folder here, you need to recompress it as a zip file, otherwise you can't install BlenderKit with Blender. Once you have Blender open, go to Edit, Preferences. We can go to Add-ons. Notice that after Blender version 4, the add-ons section is very much cleaned up. There's a new way to get extensions and add-ons directly from the Blender website. If we click this little down caret at the top, we can install from disk. If I click this item, then navigate to where you have BlenderKit zip file, select it, then select Install from Disk. Once this happens, you'll notice you have the BlenderKit Online Asset Library installed in Blender 4.2. Now I can search for all types of things, such as a hammer, and then we can see all the different hammers. Some of these have padlocks because they're only available with the paid subscription, but you can see a preview to see if you want to purchase a subscription to get that asset. Over here in the filters of BlenderKit, we can go ahead and select free first, and this will filter out the free hammers. And then if I see a hammer that I like, for example, this one, and I select it, it will come into my Blender scene. This cube is in the way, so I'll move it away, and then I'll zoom in, and I can see this hammer right here that I can rotate and move any way I want. I can close the preview of BlenderKit, look at material preview here, and then we can see how the textures are imported automatically from BlenderKit. So hopefully this helps you install BlenderKit with Blender 4.2 from a zip file and install it as a local disk add-on. Happy 3D modeling!